We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Very good morning, dear friends. Today, in our lecture number 5, we are going to discuss about VSWR, that is nothing but a voltage standing wave ratio, then power transfer in terms of the same reflected as well as forward voltage, and in addition to that, we are also going to discuss about different types of loads connected to the transmission lines and the respective situation of the load whenever it is connected on the different position on transmission line. Now, if we start with this VSWR, then we are knowing the reflection coefficient gamma is defined by the ratio of the voltage reflection wave to the incident wave at the load, and mathematically the same we can define by the equation V0 minus into e raised to gamma L upon V0 plus into e raised to minus gamma L. Now we have already derived the equation for reflected voltage as well as forward voltage in our last to last lecture. So here we are knowing that this V0 plus is 1 by 2 into VL plus Z0 into IL into e raised to gamma L. Actually here in this set of equation we are using VL, it is equal to ZL into IL. This is nothing but the multiplication of impedance into current. And same way, this V0 minus is equal to 1 by 2 into VL minus Z0 into IL into e raised to minus gamma L. So altogether, if we put this our equation in our equation of reflection coefficient with, as I told, VL, it is equal to ZL into IL, then we are getting an equation of reflection coefficient gamma is equal to ZL minus Z0 upon ZL plus Z0. So already we have derived it in our propagation chapter, the reflection coefficient is, but this reflection coefficient is representing the reflection coefficient in terms of the parameter of transmission line. Here the Z0 is, of course, we are knowing it is characteristic impedance, and ZL is load impedance of the transmission line. Now here, if we are supposed to put this reflection coefficient on different point of transmission line, then in place of, in general, L, we have to write Z. Here this is depicting in the power of E. So here reflection coefficient is equal to V0 minus into e raised to gamma Z upon V0 plus into e raised to minus gamma Z. Further, we can simplify this equation with the straightforward ratio of V0 divided V0 minus divided by V0 plus into e raised to 2 gamma Z. But here we are knowing that on the transmission line, any point from load is defined by general parameter, general length value Z. So in place of Z, we can write L minus L dash. Let me recall this stuff. If suppose this is my transmission line, here this is a point on which my ZL is connected like this, Let's say this is my ZL, this is load impedance I'm drawing here, and this is the return path. So here, if I'm measuring forward direction, then of course I'm seeing that this is nothing but the length L from source to the load terminal. Now here, if I'm talking about a certain point on a line, let's say I'm talking about the value of reflection coefficient on this point on the line, then I'm saying that this is nothing but my L dash. So this L minus L dash, this total length of transmission line, L minus the L dash, which I have already shown in this sketch, this L dash is giving us the value of Z. So we are talking about here this Z. So if you put L minus L dash in place of Z, then we are getting modified equation of this our transmission line is equal to V0 minus upon V0 plus into e raised to 2 gamma L into e raised to minus 2 gamma L dash, which is further we can rewrite with the ratio V0 minus upon V0 plus is equal to reflection coefficient, and with multiplication to it, it is e raised to minus 2 gamma L dash only. This is nothing but the term which is uncommon. Now the current reflection coefficient, same as the voltage reflection coefficient at any point, is same way we can define by means of this I0 minus into e raised to gamma L upon I0 plus into e raised to minus gamma L, and this is coming reflection coefficient itself, but the difference is the sign. Here the sign of reflection coefficient for current, it is negative. It shows that magnitude is same but direction is different, because here the current direction is opposite, unlike the voltage itself. Now more further, if we take ratio of either maximum voltage to the minimum voltage or maximum current to the minimum current, then this standing wave ratio, in general we are saying, is defined by 1 plus reflection coefficient gamma's magnitude upon 1 minus reflection coefficient gamma's magnitude. Moreover, we can also rewrite this relationship in terms of characteristic impedance. Here we can write the maximum current is equal to the maximum voltage divided by characteristic impedance, and same way the minimum current is equal to the ratio of minimum voltage divided by the characteristic impedance. Now with the help of these two relationship, very first relationship is in between standing wave ratio and reflection coefficient, along with maximum voltage and maximum current, as well as minimum voltage and current, and the characteristic impedance, we can define input impedance here. So this magnitude of input impedance we can define with the help of the same, the ratio of current V max to I mean. Here what we are doing, we are comparing this maximum input impedance with reflection coefficient as well as the characteristic impedance. So here we are saying that it is V max to I mean. Let me see you how the S is. We are knowing here, you see the S is equal to, we have seen here S is equal to Vmax by Vmin, and the Z0 here we can write from this equation. Now I can write my Z0 is equal to Vmin divided by Imin. Z0 is equal to Vmin divided by Imin. This is Imin. Vmin divided by Imin. So if I multiplying this two parameters, standing wave ratio and characteristic impedance Z0, then I'll be getting ratio Vmax by Imin. And this is nothing but the representation of input impedance of the line itself on a respective point. And same way with a similar type of ratio, we can define the magnitude of minimum input impedance with the help of the relation of Z0 and S with the division, and that is Z0 divided by S itself. So here this way we can evaluate, we can calculate, and we can derive the different relationship if one or maximum two parameters we are having. Now let us consider we are having one line which is consisting the characteristic impedance Z0 is equal to 50 and respective load impedance which is connected to it is 100 ohm, and on the load in this condition the value of load voltage is 100 volt. Of course this is RMS value. So on the load, variation of this RMS value of voltage is varying like this. Here we are showing the magnitude is continuously varying from in between, you can say that it is you see the 50 to the 100 volt. Now same way if you look to the variation of current, then the value of current is also 1 ampere effectively. You can see here this current is varying from 1 to 2 ampere, means effective variation is of 1 ampere. So such a way the variation of this AC signal is moving like this. But as and when we are having voltage maximum, current minimum and so on, the similar kind of relationship is maintaining. Here you can see this is my pi by 2. So on the pi by 2 length on the line, it is written it is beta into L radian. So on this value, the value of current is maximum. And so on, as and when if I am moving one more pi distance, this is my pi distance, then once again I am going to get the value of current is again maximum, and so on the cycle is going on. Respectively we are also having the wavelength relationship along with the degree itself. Now if we try to get the value of power, rather average power, on the distance L from the load on the transmission line, then again with the help of similar parameter we can define this power, and the equation of power is we are knowing 1 by 2 into the real component of multiplication of voltage into the complex conjugate value of current. Here no need to say that this, you know, 1 by 2 factor is needed because we are dealing with the peak value in place of the RMS value, because it is real term we have chosen. So now if we put the equation which we have derived in our previous lecture of V and I, it is nothing but Vs of Z which is equal to V0 plus into e raised to minus gamma Z plus V0 into e raised to plus gamma Z. It is V0 minus in fact plus gamma Z, and Isz, it is equal to V0 plus upon Z0 into e raised to minus gamma Z minus V0 minus upon Z0 into e raised to gamma Z. Then the simplification is giving us the equation of the average power is equal to 1 by 2 into the real component of V0 plus into e raised to j beta L plus this is reflection coefficient gamma into e raised to minus j beta L into V plus with of course complex conjugate sign divided by Z0 into e raised to minus j beta L minus this complex conjugate of the reflection coefficient gamma into e raised to j beta L. And more further if we simplify this, then we are having it is 1 by 2 into the real component of v0 plus square divided by z0 into 1 minus gamma square plus it is the reflection coefficient itself into e raised to minus 2j beta l minus the complex conjugate of reflection coefficient into e raised to 2j beta l. So in general, if we consider the last two terms are purely imaginary, then we can rewrite this our equation of power with P average is equal to V0 plus squares, rather of course magnitude square divided by 2 into Z0 into 1 minus the mode of reflection coefficient gamma square. So here the value of incident power is not a transmitted power, but the effective value over here on any point is nothing but the subtraction of the incident power to the reflected power, which is going to become a transmitted power, and this is nothing but the effective value of power transfer toward the load. Now to understand this, let us consider the different condition of load, different special cases of load which we have connected on the transmission line. So if, first of all, if I am considering whatever load I am using, it is short circuited, means in place of load we are connecting a conducting line in between two terminals of transmission line. So that now if we consider the situation, then this my value of equation of Zin, which we have derived in our last lecture, lecture number 4, then it will be represented by, simply you can say that it is Zsc, Z short circuited, it is equal to Zin whenever my ZL is equal to 0, and it is equal to J into Z0 into 10 beta L. Why this is? Because straightforward, my ZL here in this equation is 0. So that here, now if I put this relationship in equation of my reflection coefficient, which we have already seen, it is coming with the value minus 1 because of short circuit, and the voltage standing wave ratio is infinity, right? We already seen this, you know, voltage standing wave ratio here is 1 plus tau L upon 1 minus tau L. You can see here it is 1 plus tau L upon 1 minus tau L. So if you put here the same relationship, then the 1 upon 0 you will be getting, and that's why the standing wave ratio is equal to infinity. Now if you like to see the situation on the line, then this is the figure on which you can identify that the impedance over here in this condition will be either inductive or capacitive, and it is depending on the length of line. If suppose I am using my line of length beta L is equal to, let's say it is in between the 0 to pi by 2, then of course the type of load impedance represented is inductive, and so on. If I am leaving that, then it is capacitive, and so on. From one type of length to another type of length, the characteristic represented by load will be changed, and accordingly we need to consider whenever we are going to consider the further transformation of power to another block of application. Same way we can consider the open circuit line on which our ZL is equal to infinity, so nothing is connected. At that time we can say that this Zin, it is equal to ZOC at the time when our ZL is tends to infinity. At that time we can write the same our previous equation of Zin is equal to Z0 divided by J into 10 beta L. This is equal to minus J into Z0 into cot beta L. We can rewrite this. If you simplify this, then our reflection coefficient again is 1, and our value of standing wave ratio is equal to infinity here, and the difference is what, up to here 0 to pi by 2, now characteristic offering by our load is capacitive, and in between pi by 2 to pi, it will be inductive and so on. The characteristic is varying from the length of transmission line itself. Now, if suppose we are having match line on which we are having value of ZL is equal to Z0. At the time, our Z in is going to become same Z0. So here this is complete match case, and whenever complete match we are getting, at that time the reflection coefficient is equal to 0. What it shows, there is not availability of any reflected voltage wave. In general, there is no any reflected signal, and because of that the term is 0 and standing wave ratio is equal to 1. So here it is the case in which the maximum power is transferred to the load from the source via transmission line, right? So this was what about the different case and the condition in which we can get the maximum power transmission along with a certain of a very specific characteristic by the load, like inductive as well as capacitive. So as and when the selection of the type of load is defined by the type of application on which we would like to incorporate this our circuit or this our design. So this was what about our today's lecture. Now in our coming lecture, we are going to discuss about the application of transmission line in terms of impedance matching, and in addition to that, we are also going to see the introduction, basic designing and other things about Smith chart, and how to deal with the single stub and double stub matching of the transmission line with the help of Smith chart. That is also we are going to see very rigorously in our next lecture, right? But before you look to our next lecture, all this last 2 to 3 lectures of this our chapter is required to once again refer and once again verify to get the very clear and very appropriate feeling of the stuff. Right, so thank you very much all of you to listen this lecture carefully, and once again very soon we are meeting with our upcoming lecture of Smith chart as well as the application of transmission line. Once again, thank you all of you. Good day.